Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper.
Not until I see it first. You know the rules, Dad. Max, tell him.
Whoa, hey. You look totally pale. Are you okay?
Yeah. I just... Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, Chloe. Give me the thumbs up or thumbs down.
Well, I might just allow this one into the family album.
You're the boss.
What is this?
But not the cook.
William is here.
Daddy.
Yes,
and
we can't.
Chloe is just a kid.
And serve us slackers.
Am I that far back in time?
You mean pancakes?
In France, they call them
crepes. I'm 18 years old inside my 13-year-old self.
If you want to eat.
How?
We. I volunteer to break the eggs.
Do you remember how many eggs?
Mom said it depends.
That's true.
So, how many eggs?
Don't you dare question the chef.
Right, like you're the real cook here.
Hello and welcome back, everybody, to Charsur. We are playing Life is Strange Part 9? Yeah. It's been a while since I played this game. I apologize for that. I've had a lot of stuff going on. If you guys have stayed tuned to some of my videos, I went through a lot of personal problems going on. I'm still working on those personal problems still. I'm doing a lot better. And I thought, you know what? I think Life's Strange. I need to pick that back up and do this.
Hey,
so
honey.
I'm going to do it.
Just making a fabulous breakfast with Chloe and Max.
So
we're all going to work at the Two Whales.
Yeah, let's get back to this. We are back with Max, and we are back in time. If you haven't seen the last episode, you should definitely check that out. No worries.
Joyce loves William so much.
We're so proud of your promotion. You get a week of Two Whales waffles in your house. Your loving wifey.
Now I'll have an excuse to get a mocha. Be there shortly. Love you.
I have to stop William from taking his car today.
Ladies, I have to go rescue yonder queen at the Save Mart.
I know I've seen those pictures before.
Excuse me, ladies.
She doth have many bags of delicious grub for us to feast upon.
You are ridiculous.
That's a cool snow dough.
Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund. Keys, please.
What did I do? I wrote graffiti on it. That's weird.
I know they
so
never
So I definitely have to
vacation.
Find hide the keys.
Aha!
Aha! You're not getting those keys! I don't think. Gosh dang it. Give me those keys. I can't grab the keys?
Oh yeah, I miss movie nights here. Cookies and popcorn.
Now lock up after I leave.
What the heck? Do I have to wait like a bunch? Alright, get away. Come on, go away. I guess I just have to, like, completely wait for him to leave. Leave. Okay, maybe...
I have to go rescue yonder queen at the
yes.
She don't
school's
have
a dweeb.
Delicious grub for us to feast
you are
upon.
Ridiculous.
He'll be grateful for that someday. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar!
You mean your college fund. Keys, please.
Where are your keys? Where would they be?
What a mess we made.
Shit, where are the
I remember
keys?
Those cool drawings I did with Chloe.
Another dollar for the swear jar!
You're bankrupting me!
Chloe was so into manga. Nice hair.
Heck yeah. Hey, what's up?
I knew this thing would come in handy. How the hell did my keys end up here? And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
Dad!
Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world-famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert. Max, you'll be here too, right?
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us.
Oh, wait. So am I really trying to reverse time and make sure her dad's okay? Am I really trying to do that right now? Like, I'm trying to change time to that extent? That's absolutely crazy. I'm just standing there. Hello.
You'll be grateful for that someday. Shit, where are my keys?
No, that's not what I want to do. It's not what I wanted to do. Give me the keys, give me the keys, give me the keys. Now, how... Is he grabbing his thing, or... I guess I'm just... Okay, sorry!
You remember how many eggs?
Mom said it depends.
That's true.
So, how many eggs?
Don't you dare question the chef.
Right.
Why would I do this?
Disconnected.
No!
I am. When your mom is away.
I'll let her know that.
I'll talk to him. Hello!
Mr. Price, in case you're thinking about using your car, I heard there's awful traffic and road construction, so you shouldn't drive at all.
There's no way that's gonna work.
Max, you are the road warrior. I promise, if I have to go anywhere, I'll drive like I'm taking a test. Fair enough?
Not really. I just know the roads are bad and stuff, so you...
Since you're obviously my personal GPS, I feel safer already. So don't look so worried, Max.
He's kind of a dweeb dad. Don't you worry. Don't you worry. Yeah. I'm gonna hide my keys right there. Yeah, I should do that. Oh, okay, can't go that way. So they're just gonna... Wait, what's this? Oh, he has a cell phone on him! No! Doesn't matter if I'm talking to you.
Now I get to take a picture. Strike a pose.
Make me a star.
Alright.
Just make me look young.
I am changing the future right now. And I don't like it.
Listen, don't let your dad take his car today. I know it sounds weird, but please believe me. Something terrible is going to happen. You have to stop him from driving anywhere.
Whatever, weirdo. What kind of thing is that to say about my dad?
I'm not joking.
Then you stop him, Supermax.
Thanks. Thanks for helping. What do I do? Yes! Perfect.
Hey, honey. I have no idea what...
He'll never be able to find him.
I know I had those keys right here. I know it.
Yep. Never gonna find
him. Forgot all about you, little buddy. Release the keys! Of course. Last time I ordered from Spy Guy Electronics.
You can take the bus, right? The stop is right down the street.
This I can do. Good call, Max.
Oh yeah, the bus is great. It comes every 15 minutes and there'll be plenty of room for you and Joyce and groceries and it'll save the environment.
You sold me already. I'm off to yonder bus stop. Joyce will love this.
Chloe knows something's up. Why am I, like, giving
Max,
it away?
Max, you're being so fucking strange. You feel
life
okay?
Is strange.
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
This, whoa, what's going on right now? I'm supposed to do this. It didn't give me the option to not do this. What's gonna change? This is really cool though. I really am enjoying that. We jumped like right into it.
I'm not paying $150 for a concert?
I heard that the Vortex Club parties are wild.
Dude, the service fee is like 50%.
Hello? Are you even listening, Maxine?
All my friends in LA told me that Oregon was
Max.
Going to be wet and cold every day.
Never, like Maxine.
So that's why she was laughing so hard.
I know. Sorry, Mad Max. You're not pissed at me, right? Right? Do you want
to
go hit the girls' potty and smoke a peace pipe?
I think Max is hot.
She's acting like so weird. You cool, Max?
Nobody listened when I said we shouldn't let her in the Vortex.
Courtney, you don't want anybody in the club.
Like, whatever, bitch.
Warren, he hooked up with Stella?
Good. They're meant for each other. That's really creepy of me to just be like, hey, what's up? I'm just gonna walk by.
Oh no, this is totally fucked up. What else have I changed?
A lot of stuff has changed.
Chloe.
Yeah, what happened to her? She gave me on that bus? It's David. Hello, David. What? This just got super interesting. Every single episode, it's like every other episode, I'm either like not into it at all, or it just does this super awesome thing like this, and I'm just like, whoa, this got good. This is awesome. Ah, man, this is so cool. I hope Chloe's okay. And her dad and all that stuff. I'm pretty sure that's where I'm going right now. Probably to the diner. No, I hope they don't end up like having a really unhappy ending. It's so weird seeing David like that. Oh, what? Whoa, what's... Wait, whoa. It's two wells on a beach. They're not going to be alive, are they? I'm not gonna be alive. Oh no, no, please, 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 please.
Max Caulfield, taking a break after taking Seattle by storm, huh? We thought we'd never see you again after you left for the big city.
No. I'd never do that to Chloe.
Speaking of, I know she's been dying to see you. Hold on. Chloe! You have a visitor!
A visitor? He's very soft-spoken. No! Whoa, what happened? That was the end, wasn't it? That was the end. Okay, that was 15 minutes of the Chaos series, so we're going to go to the next one. I didn't realize it was going to be that soon, so don't mind that. We're going to start the next one. But wow, that was crazy. So we changed it, but maybe not for the better. What could have happened? I mean, so much changed, so many little things changed. Oh my gosh, that's crazy. I don't know what to think of that, because that's just like... That's it. Well, that's a cliffhanger. And thank goodness we don't have to wait for that cliffhanger to stop. So, yeah. So... We'll take a look at our choices, all that stuff, and then we'll go from there. And then we'll start the next one, because I'm not going to do that to you guys. I'm not going to be like, let's start the next one in the next episode, because this is 16 minutes of episode. It's like, no, I'm here to play an hour worth, or maybe an hour and a half now, you know? Just here to do our thing, you know? So hold on for that. All right, and we're back, guys. And a lot of our choices are pretty different. Not gonna lie. 53% of people stole the money. That's ridiculous, guys. Come on. That's charity money. So, screw you guys. Don't do that. 80% kiss Chloe. Woo! Did right there, I suppose. Holy crap. 16% sided with David. Okay, so I think I should explain myself a little bit with that. David and Chloe do not get along. David has a temper. Chloe has a temper. I think the fact that they both have tempers is why they get on each other's bad side. David just kind of wants what's best for people, but he also goes a little bit too far with it. So I think that he's not in the wrong. I think Chloe's kind of just being a brat at the moment, but I feel like Chloe and David are both in the wrong here, but David's a little bit more right. That's why I sided with David, really. 8% of you are horrible, horrible people. All of us good people kept Frank's dog from harm. And 68% of us has helped Chloe have a gun. That is good that Frank does not have the gun. So, awesome. Okay. Oh, that looks like somebody's gun that I remember. Can't wait. All right, let's continue. Let's get this show on the road. So wait a sec. If everything changed in this one, does that mean,
Previously on Life is Strange.
Whoa.
Forgot her name.
You don't know who the fuck Kate? I am or who you're messing around with.
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Is Kate still in the hospital?
Let's talk about your superpower.
What are you doing here, Max?
To save you.
Stop! Don't come near me.
Not now. It won't work.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us. Miss Caulfield, please, tell us everything.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
Max, we have to find Rachel soon. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues.
Welcome to my domain. Let's find what we want and beat it.
Max, you better come check out these files. Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it. Listen, I found pictures of Rachel and Frank being more than friends. I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
No, you don't.
Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? Ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
That is such a dramatic change.
Hello, are you even listening, Maxine?
This is totally fucked up. What else have I changed?
Max Caulfield, hold on. Chloe, you have a visitor.
It's kind of sad. Chloe doesn't deserve that. We'll see what we can do. I forgot about that Rachel's in the dark room part, though. That is kind of creepy. Somebody insane's behind what happened. Let's find out what happened. That's what we gotta do, man. We gotta find out. Well, I know for sure. Never mind. I was about to say. I know for sure that Chloe didn't take one of those bikes. Sorry. Ooh, we get to find out about the dark room! I guess. So can she talk? Or is she, was it act? I don't know. I guess we'll find out. Such a romantic walk on the beach with all the dead whales. I'm a big fan.
Nothing more than a relaxing walk across the land with all the dead carcasses on
route. It's weird hanging out with you again.
I know.
Talk. Okay.
I'm glad we are, though.
It was nice that you sent me actual letters. It's more than any of my other friends have done. And you even wrote on that cool parchment paper. It's so Max.
So pretentious. But I love writing on it like an English poet. You deserve the best stationery.
Probably easier to write than to visit me. I don't mean that in a bitchy way. Not totally. You probably wanted to avoid awkward conversations like this.
Pretty much. Yeah.
The worst thing you can do is treat me like a baby. I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend. Can we stop? This is seriously the best view of the sunset. What do photographers call that?
The golden hour.
Picture of a sunset.
See? Without you here, I'd have no clue. Bet you could take some amazing shots. Those beached whales are so sad. I kind of know how they feel. At least, I'm alive here with you.
You're a real survivor, Chloe. I know you have to deal with so much.
I don't want anybody else feeling sorry for me. I can do that. Along with my parents. My dad still feels guilty about buying me that car.
Oh, no.
Are you okay to talk about the accident?
We never actually have, huh? There's not much to say. Some prick in an SUV cut me off and I flew into a ditch.
Do you remember everything?
I saw everything in bullet time. I felt my back snap and that was the last thing I ever felt in my body.
Well,
when I woke up in the hospital, I literally couldn't move a muscle.
Jesus. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. I'm just happy I did get to see you again. I could have ended up vanishing out of the blue like that girl from Blackwell.
You mean Rachel Amber? When was the last time you talked to her?
Never. I just read about her in the news. I didn't even know her name. You did?
This is such a different world than when we were kids, isn't it?
After that snow mm-hmm. and eclipse, it's more like the end of the world.
Whoa, what? Whoa, so that actually did happen too.
Do you think so? I haven't kept up with the details.
I have more time on my hands than you. Plus, I'm a science nerd. But none of this makes sense.
I know things seem out of control, but as long as we're together, I don't feel afraid.
Hanging out with you makes me feel like a total kid again. You don't even know.
Listen, Chloe, I'm sorry I haven't been out to see you more. That was wrong. You're my best friend.
This is really trippy.
Max, thanks for coming out to see me. You're doing awesome.
I don't think so.
My nose is getting cold. Maybe we should get back to my place?
It is hella cold out here.
Hella? I hate that word. No offense.
No! You can't hate that word! She's taking a gasp. She's like, what? No! You say that all the time! How dare you! I can't believe that. I can't believe that.
Well, I'm glad I got to catch up with ya. Have a great day.
That could have gone better. Maybe I can go back in time and reverse the car. Then everything will work out then. That's what I would do. But then it probably wouldn't end up working. Something else would happen or something else would happen. Stack, 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 you know. And
Oh, it's a pretty high-tech lair.
Feels like a high-tech cell. But I am lucky my parents bust their ass to take care of me. I know it's hard for them.
They're grateful you're here with them.
Right. Especially when they can't even take a walk alone. Sometimes I act like a total teenage brat just to give them an excuse to yell at me. Pathetic, I know.
What?
Chloe, you're a great daughter. You're kind and sensitive. When you don't even have to be.
Trust me, I still get my rage on. Especially when a nurse has to watch while I take a dump so she can wipe my bum. Or when doctors flip me around like I was a science doll.
I can't even imagine. But you're still amazing. You always have been since we were kids.
Thanks again for coming, Max. I, need to get my drink on. Can you bring me some water?
This is so much different. This is her room? Whoa. No, this isn't her room. Whose room is this?
Hello, Chloe. She likes fluffy animals now.
Am I gonna be a total jerk about this?
The snow dough. I guess not everything changed.
I mean, I'm pretty sure those wouldn't change, but whatever.
Snow globes are taking over. That's a serious heat lamp. Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood?
Wait, this is out back?
She can't even feel the grass now.
No.
I'm glad I took this photo. Chloe has a new memory of William and her together.
But I hope Max is going through the thinking and being like, is this better than what it was? And I hope that she's thinking that it's not. For Chloe, anyway. It's good that her dad's alive, because the dad's still in her life, but... Oh, it's absolutely crazy. I don't know. I'd be seriously thinking, like, about that. Like, the pros and the cons and all
Chloe
that.
At least Chloe doesn't weigh that much.
I mean, that's not good. Max.
Oh, man. She has to use that ventilator just to breathe.
I literally walk around the room just like, hey, I'm gonna look at all this other stuff. It's fine.
Whoa, Chloe can totally control her computer. It's so great people get this high-tech help.
There's the old Chloe. I should offer to put makeup on for Chloe. Not that I can, but it would be fun. Man, Joyce and William built a whole new bathroom for Chloe. They're so great.
That's really cool of them.
It's nice my parents sent a card at least.
You and you're in our hearts and thoughts. We hope to see your smiling face soon. Please be well, Ryan and Vanessa Caulfield. Thinking of you.
I wonder who this is. Kind of a generic card.
Thinking of you. Dear Chloe, I am so sorry for what happened. Know that I am here for you. If you need anything, I hope you feel better, and I hope to see you again. She's probably the girl in the SUV. Maybe. I don't know.
I wasn't very available to Chloe. Real nice.
Chloe, just thought I'd drop you a quick note to let you know I'm thinking about you. I feel so lame, writing shit like, I hope you are well, etc. I know your life is so different now, and I don't want that to get in the way of our friendship. Yes, I haven't been around lately, but that will change soon. I hope you are well. Ugh.
At least I sent road trip selfies to Chloe. I'm sure that made her feel great.
Yeah, you're kind of mean, Max. I mean, already you're really mean.
I still can't believe I put Chloe in that chair.
I mean, yeah, you kind of did, I guess. All right, let's get you the water. Now that I'm done, you know, walking around, take my time. Here's some water.
Drink up, Buttercup. Oh, man. No wonder my throat is dry. I don't think I've talked this much the whole year. Have you ever thought about doing a podcast or something?
I wish I could punch your face right now. A podcast? Dude, I am a pod in a cast. Boring.
Ouch. It was just a thought.
No, I would love to hear her.
I know you're just trying to help.
Yeah, that's become a bad habit of mine.
You sound like an adult now. It seems like we were kids in another life.
What did you remember?
What do you remember about us as kids? We all have different memories.
I think about us as little pirates running and jumping through Arcadia Bay.
Me too. But we're still pirates in our own way.
Yeah, right. Check me out, Chloe of the Caribbean. No way will I get on a fucking boat now. Unless you're with me. As you can see, I can't keep all my other friends away.
Which friends? Yeah.
Which friends did you hang out with the most?
Megan Weaver, but you don't know her. She was cool. But after my accident, she was too cool for school.
I know I wasn't around much. No excuses, I'm a loser. But I am trying to make things right.
How? Dude, you're not Supermax. And I'm not trying to guilt trip you. That's what my parents are for.
Yeah, what's going
on?
Are
they okay? I mean, are they still happy together and everything?
So now you're Dr. Bill? I guess they're good, considering they have to deal with me. They laugh and hold hands. And I hope they still get busy, too.
I think Joyce and William are incredible.
Max, the accident has been so hard on them. Our insurance sucks, and the medical bills are fucking insane.
Can I bet.
Pay all the bills?
No way. They keep the numbers away from me, but it doesn't take much research to find out I'm costing my parents almost $1 million a year.
Oh!
You're priceless. No pun intended.
You are such a geek. That's why I love you. Of course, I know a geek when I be one. See, I'm practically a human entertainment system. It would be sweet to chill out together and watch a movie, like when you'd spend the night at my house.
What do you want to watch?
I think I'm in, like, a mellow Blade Runner mood. I always cry at the end. Plus, you know I always wanted to have cool colored bangs like Pris.
I know. You would look incredible with blue hair. Now let's get this show on the road. And you better not fall asleep on me like you always do when we watch movies.
I remember, Max. Swear I won't fall asleep. Not when you're here. Not yet.
What does that mean?
That must be her mighty morphine machine. No more bongs for her. Nothing but medical supplies. She has to use a lot of lotion to keep her blood circulating.
Wait, really?
Thanks. I think you missed a grain stuck in my eyeball.
Hard to believe how just a little sand can cause such a big mess.
It's like that Chinese proverb, a spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. You know, like the butterfly thing.
So I've heard.
Yeah.
Chloe is still a punk at heart. But she can't stage dive anymore.
That's true.
That's so cool that Chloe has made friends online.
Welcome to Hot Wheels chat room. What? Handy Bob, for your safety, do not give any personal information to any person in this chat room. You are responsible for knowing the chat room rules. Miss Blue, so what are you doing? Ignitus, talking with you? Ha ha, no shit. I'm about to binge on Quantum Leap. OMG, love Scott Bakula rules. So do you. I hope you can meet soon. Not if you're in San Francisco. Hey, I have to take care of some body work. Let me get back to you while you're binging on Bakula. You better. Hello? Well, goodness, that's not good. I mean, she's making friends, yeah, that's good, yeah, but she is being kind of a, yeah, kind of a catfish. All right. Definitely going to be in, here, I bet. Yep.
Here's the DVD.
Oh,
my God. I made that mix for her when we were 12.
Aw, pirate power. You're a good artist, too.
So cool that you're here again.
I'm glad you think so.
Yeah. Not yet. That's not good. Please don't be what I think you are. I care about you too much. You're annoying and you're awful, but you're great at the same time. Did the kiss matter in this alternate reality? She didn't even fall asleep. It's not good. Also, if she had a choice, she'd probably have styled the room way differently.
I cannot believe you fell asleep so fast. How dare you?
I know you were beat down after the day with me, and Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No, I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me.
You are a bitch in the morning.
It's the company I keep. Yesterday was such a blast.
It was great seeing you.
I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates, jumping and running through the forests again. It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit. Fuck. I'm getting my regular head pains. Can you pretty please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom?
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep the swag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. Like a pirate, right?
I'm on it, Chloe.
Okay, I'm gonna go do that right now.
Damn. This is just for Chloe's basic supplies.
Man.
Bonjour. That's great they finally went to Paris.
Uh-oh, Victoria texts me. Max, you busy girl? Avoiding homework as usual. I told you I'd help you out. You never let me help. Okay. Okay, drama, stop. And you help me by caring. I do try. By the way, I scored the killer bud from you-know-who, FYI. Save me a bowl. Gotta bounce. Talk to you later. Come to my room tonight. Max, are we cool? Just wanted to make sure. Da-da-da, you walked too fast. Nathan was worried, too. If you want to talk, hit me up, okay? Love you. Max, if you're mad, just tell me, okay? Silence. So if you want to talk, my door is open. Love you. Uh-oh. Hello, Max. This is William. If you want to contact Chloe, you can use this number. She would love to hear from you. See you soon, I hope. Bye. Hey, Chloe. Maxine here. I hope... I know it's been a while. I just wanted to let you know I'm going to Blackwell Academy soon. I hope this is still your number. Max is back. Blackwell, that is so awesome. You rule. Best of all, we can hang again. So, yes, this is still my number. Cool. I've got a buttload of homework, but we'll get together soon. Don't tease me. It's been too long. I know. I'll see you soon. Okay, Taylor. Max, thanks again for taking me to see your mom. I think she wants you for a daughter instead of me. I think not. Your mom is a badass like you. Yeah, right. I cried like a bitch. So did I. You just didn't see. It's okay to cry. Gets old. My stupid phone is about to die, so call me back. Aw. Nathan. Yo, yo, Max, you around? In the dark room, developing shots for the contest. Sweet. So no... two wells for you? Not yet. I'll see you guys later, though. Peace out. Ooh, gosh. What's going on? Happy birthday, Maxime. Can't believe it's been 18 whole years since you were brought to us. That was 0921. Maxime, this is your mom. We need to talk about some of your bills. Are you there? Yes, give me some time to answer. I can't just text in every class. Some teachers get super pissed when people use their phone. Yes, because it's super rude, and please don't be so snippy. Sorry, long day of homework. Homework. You're not the only one, and that's why we're wondering if you need to spend so much. We want you to have everything you need, but your scholarship doesn't cover everything. You said I could use your credit card when I needed it. I only bought film, not a camera. Maybe it's time to go digital. I'll call you later. I have to go. Don't pout. Love you. Hey, honey, I hope you didn't forget to water the plant we gave you, but don't drown it either, mommy. Oh, nah! Alyssa. Hey, Max, it's a shame that you hang out with those people. I thought you were different. Alyssa, I saw you throw that TP at me. OMG, I was so not aiming at you. I swear, don't do it again. Man! Max, you're a meanie. Oh, man.
They gave Chloe their giant expensive HDTV. And they use our shitty tube television.
Mmm. Nice China, at least. That's good.
To think that our destiny is linked to goddamn car keys.
Yep. Yep. That is crazy. What's that?
They might get their own home taken away because of medical bills. That's terrible.
Cool. This letter is notified that you are in the default of your payment obligations as your home loan account number. Da, 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 da. This current account holds the amount of $12,000 payable by August 1st, 2013. This amount has been overdue since March 1st, 2009, and you have ignored multiple requests to make a payment or consolidate your debt. Unless the full amount of $12,000 is received within... Oh, wow. That's great. Oh, my gosh. Within 15 days, we must begin the foreclosure process on your home. We have given you the more adequate notice of this issue, and we have no other options left. Best, Donald Clamp Lenders. You're so nice.
Hey, William. Am I bothering you?
Why, yes, Max. I love going through bills. Kidding. How can you bother me? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. You look exactly the same. It's so cool.
Good. Or I'd be scared if I didn't look like me. Of course, you seem more adult now. So what's on your mind?
I'm going to talk about
everything.
I don't
know how to say this, but I'm truly sorry about what happened to Chloe.
Me too. All it takes is a few minutes to change a girl's whole life. But she's alive. She's been a trooper.
Is she mad at me for not staying in touch? She should be. I have no excuse.
She was disappointed, but she knows you care. And I know how hard it is to process all this. It's taken us years.
William, I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll always be here for Chloe. Always.
I know you will, Max.
So you finally made it to Paris.
Oui, as they say. Not me, because I can't speak French. But it was a great experience, especially for Chloe.
I can see her loving it there. You guys rock for going on a family adventure like that.
She talked about going to school there, but that's not practical anymore. It's not fair, Max.
I was impressed by Chloe's room and all the high-tech equipment.
You should be. We could buy a few mansions for what it all costs. Insurance helps, but I don't know, Max.
I know it must be hard on you guys, financially.
His bills are more like crushing. We have to mortgage our home, and that's pretty scary. But we'll get through it. Price is always right. Get it? No?
Being around you and Joyce again is so nostalgic.
Very old school, as they say. I think it's great for Chloe to see you. Makes Joyce happy, too. So, it's not all bad news in Arcadia Bay. Or is it?
What's going on?
The Prescott family might be bad news. What do you think about them?
Evil. Next question?
Sounds like you know them well.
More than I want to. But Joyce has to work for those greedy bastards at Pan Estates. I don't even like to think about it.
Whoa.
What do you think is going on
crazy
with
weather
all of this crazy weather and animals dying?
Nobody knows, right? It is Nostradamus-type shit, pardon my French. But all I actually care about now is Chloe and Joyce. My family.
I was reading about that missing girl. Rachel Amber.
Oh, yes. She went to Blackwell, right? Oh, poor thing. That's a real nightmare for a family. I get scared thinking about Chloe and that we might lose her someday.
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything.
Yeah, leave. No, get out of there. That's awkward.
It was so great talking with you again.
You act like it's the last time. And please, keep me from these bills whenever you want.
They did really good on the eyes on Max.
These whales are just a preview of the tornado to come. And the Prescott Foundation? Jesus.
I was about to provide extra research funds given the total scope of this.
Rachel Amber is even missing in this reality. I guess I can't change everything.
Where did they go? The Amber family has offered a reward for any information. Blah, 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 blah. Alright.
Joyce is a food coupon boss.
Seems like so.
No change to spare anymore. Now it's back to cookies.
Hey, cookies is good. Alright, it's upstairs. I've left Max, Chloe. I've left her standing there for too long. Damn it. Okay. Switch on. Switch off.
Nothing here.
Probably nothing in here is
it's
what
cool
I would hope.
Chloe uses natural medicine too.
Yeah.
The bathroom looks almost the same. Just more medicine.
I can't wait to see how Chloe's room looks.
Here it is. I never thought I'd be delivering morphine to my best friend.
Why didn't I just
How's it going, Time Tripper? Funny. I think I look older.
I do. Yeah, let's check this out.
Oh, they have nothing? They're not even using that room? They could have, like, rented it out or something. That could help with bills. Just storage? That's it?
A blue butterfly? I'm sure this is a total coincidence.
Must be.
At least we never had to hide from Step Douche.
True. Oh. Do.
I guess we stopped growing up together.
Guess so. What's this?
I never heard much about William's brother.
Hi, Bill. Sorry for not staying in touch since the accident. Work has been piling up, and I'm being sent to Salt Lake City to oversee a new parking lot. You have to go where the work is there these days. I wish I could have sent you a bigger check out, but you know the story. Money's nobody's favorite thing. Maybe I'll see you next spring for a visit. Kiss Chloe and Joyce for me. Hang in there, Bill. Your brother, Aaron. It's good of him to send him money.
Chloe always did love stomping around in her boots. Toys? I kind of want to open this and see what's in here.
Well, I should do it then. Except not.
They bought crutches for Chloe, hoping she might walk again.
Who knows? Who knows?
Too bad Joyce and William can't get any help from the Prescott Foundation.
Dear Joyce, thank you for keeping me updated on Chloe's condition. I can only imagine the struggle you and William are going through. I'm so sorry that I can't help you with a loan at this time. Like everybody else, I'm underwater with my own medical bills. Please give Chloe a hug and my best wishes. Love, Aunt Dorothy. I've been asking family, which they should be. Man, that is so trippy.
I'm still overwhelmed by this new reality. I feel so guilty for putting Chloe and her family through this. I could give Chloe the choice of keeping William alive, but that would be cruel.
Yeah, but you're gonna have to make that decision.
But then I see that they're a family again, and who am I to judge?
Now that would be crazy if it gave you the choice to make that decision. That would be crazy, if it will, but I don't know. Oh man, that's crazy. All right, let's go give her the thing. All right. All right, let's get you your morphine, girl.
Finally. Give me the blue pill. I'm sorry. I'm nosy, but not precise. Go ahead and plug it right in. It's so easy. And painless. Okay, but get ready to yell for your folks if I screw up.
Oh, trust me. I will.
Wait, what?
Of course my pain just keeps getting worse. But you caught me on a good day. Max, I'm so grateful that I'm even able to hang out with you. See, I'm getting mushy. I'm already high.
You're so adorable. Do you want anything else?
Stop me if I'm being too emo, but can you grab one of the photo albums over there? I'd like to check out some old pictures of us when we were kids.
Please, my diary is like emo ground zero. Plus, Max Caulfield does not pass up a photo op with Chloe Price. Ever.
Better not. Better be cool. Better. How dare you? How dare you, Max? Be the way you are.
Despite everything, they're still a happy family again.
That's true.
It's cool that in this reality, Chloe really loves skating too. Wowzer. Chloe was a straight A student. She could have gone to any college.
Seems like so.
What a bastard. I totally should have let Chloe steal your bullshit fund.
even if it wasn't another reality.
Wait, what? Okay, let me see this. As principal, I am in sympathy with your numerous requests for Chloe's special needs in regards to her wheelchair and class accessibility, etc. Blackwell prides itself on making sure students with disabilities receive full compliance under the Americans with Disabilities Act. However, given that the campus and buildings have all been constructed pre-1977, our school has not yet undergone the modern renovations necessary to fulfill all the needs of your daughter in regrettable condition. Sadly, with decent deplorable federal cuts in education, it will take many more fundraisers to fully update Blackwell Academy. But that day will come. Chloe is without a doubt an amazing student with great potential despite her handicap, and I believe she would find a more fitting, rewarding scholastic environment at the H. West Institute in Bolton. They have a rich legacy of disabled graduates, and I know that Chloe would achieve her usual academic leadership in more comfortable surroundings. With her outstanding GPA, there is no doubt that Miss Katonic would welcome Chloe with open halls. I hope you will seriously consider this suggestion, as I am sure your daughter would prefer to attend a school that can cater to her many needs. In the same spirit, I have also enclosed brochures for other potential schools in the Oregon region. If you have any questions, please contact my office. Sincerely. My goodness, I'm burping like crazy. Sorry. Sincerely, Principal Wells. Well, you're kind of a jerk, aren't you? Had that $5,000. Gosh dang it! Was that not a good decision? It must have not been a good decision. All right, let's look at it, Chloe.
Is that okay?
Perfect. Oh my God, look how little we are there. We look like toys.
I remember that day by the lighthouse.
My dad was pissed at us. He actually tried to give us a timeout.
And you laughed at him. My dad would have banished me.
Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance.
There's still time for you.
And you. No,
Oh man, there we are making pancakes. I love that shot of us. It's hard to believe my dad took that picture only 5 years ago.
Literally seems like yesterday.
I wish it was.
Me too. This photo. Maybe I could.
Listen, Max. My respiratory system is failing, and it's only getting worse. I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out. So I know I'm just putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along, and I will too. This isn't how I want things to end.
What? What are you saying?
She wants me to unplug her. No!
I'm saying that being with you again has been so special. I just wanted to feel like when we were kids running around Arcadia Bay and everything was possible, and you made me feel that way today. I want this time with you to be my last memory.
Oh no!
You understand?
Yes, I do.
All you have to do is crank up the IV to 11.
What? Oh no. I'm tearing up. No, really? What?
This is too much, I think. That's just crazy. I don't know what to do with that. I don't know what to do with that. Accept, refuse, I don't know. Shoot. Accept.
Chloe, I'll just drift to sleep, dreaming of us here together. Forever. Thank you so much. I'm so proud of you for following your dreams. Don't forget about me.
Never.
I love you, Max. See you around.
Sooner than you think. Sorry, William.
That was intense. That was really
someday
intense.
Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper. Hello? Hey, honey. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund? Jeez. Aha! You can't hide from me forever.
I'm just gonna throw the photo into the...
And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
What?
Dad!
Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world-famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert. Max, you'll be here too, right?
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. Like you're never gonna see us again.
Chloe, I'm so sorry. I tried to make things different for you. I did try. I'm sorry.
I don't know exactly what you're talking about, but come on. You have made things different, like my whole life. You're my best friend. I've got you and a great family. What's to be sorry for? We'll be best friends forever. And when we grow up, we're taking over the world.
Listen, whatever happens, I want you to be strong. Even if you feel like I wasn't there for you. Because I will never abandon you, Chloe. I'll always have your back. Always.
Gosh, dang it. We finally did it. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Holy crap. Holy crap, though. My all. That's fucking crazy. Excuse me, but that is fucking crazy. That made me cry. That was a lot.
Chloe, you're alive. Yes.
Whoa, down, Max. You get one kiss, now you're all over me?
I'm so glad you're here.
You sound high, but thanks for the morning grope. Since we were up all night playing CSI Arcadia Bay, I was still spaced out here trying to put all this info together. Max, did you forget we've gone over this? I hope you weren't messing around with time while I was sleeping.
Not anymore. I'm just spaced out too. Welcome back to the real world, Max. I don't think I can ever tell Chloe about what happened.
Definitely, no. Never tell her what happened. Holy crap, though. That was absolutely crazy. That was absolutely crazy, guys. That was... Oh my gosh. Life is Strange, how in the heck do you keep doing this? My hell. Okay. That's a good point to end this episode. Oh my gosh, that was so intense. Thank you all for joining me for this amazing episode. We're just barely getting started. I mean, this is episode 4 and there's one more, and I can legitimately say it's picked up. And my goodness, that was awesome and amazing, and it made me cry. And I hope that you guys experienced something with that, because oh my gosh, that was amazing and just so emotional, and having to go through that is crazy. Whew. I'm still emotional for that. Oh gosh. Oh. Thank you all again. Thank you all. And I guess this is a good moment as any to tell you guys that I am going to counselors and I am getting help. I feel a lot happier than I did at that initial moment, and I am getting better. And I encourage anybody to seek, if they feel anxious or depressed or alone or not loved or anything, that you are loved and you are cared for, and that the best way to figure this out is to talk to someone about this. To talk. And tell you the truth, it feels really good to talk to a stranger, and I highly recommend talking to a counselor. It doesn't work for everybody, but it might work for you. So if you are going through that, and if you need help and you want to get that help, then you should really, really consider getting that help. Because you are loved. You are cared for. Seriously. Help me, it might help you. Thank you all for watching this. And with that, guys, I wish you peace, love, and happiness. I'll see you guys in the next episode, because I'm not stopping. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you all have a good day, a good day, a good night, a good everything. Just that was awesome. Thank you, guys. I'll see you in the next episode.